Hi, I'm David, and I have a simple, very simple little illustration that I hope will help you to understand who you are and how you can relate to other people. Pretty simple, as a matter of fact. Here you are, the person. Scripture says that you are fearfully and wonderfully made, and that you need to learn who you are in all different kinds of wonderful ways. But what happens as we interact with more and more and more people, we sometimes will develop attitudes, or we will even have some kind of behaviors, or we may even have, interestingly enough, some kind of illness that sooner or later people will label us as the attitude, or as the behavior, or as the illness. So many times, well, he is a bipolar, or he is a thief, or he is a liar, or he has some terrible attitudes that really aren't very becoming as far as that's concerned. And what happens is we start drawing an equal sign here between these two. So when we think of the person, we actually start thinking of them this way rather than this way. Well, I think one of the wonders of how we're made and of the kingdom that we live in is that Christ came and said, I've come to erase these and to cover these over, so that when God looks at you and when God thinks of you, he is able to put a not equal sign here. I think this is one of the most wonderful parts of being a believer, is that when once we've accepted Christ as Savior, and we know that even our misbehaviors and even our bad attitudes and sometimes even our illnesses can be healed through his power and through his love and his grace, then we can start thinking of ourselves like this, as people who are loved and who are cherished and who God can look at and say, this is my beloved. That's one of the most wonderful parts of who we are. So for next time you think of yourself as maybe even labeling yourself as this misbehavior or as this bad attitude or even this illness, try to make that paradigm shift over here and start thinking of yourself as this beautiful, lovely, wonderful person that God made and that Christ died for.